Ask the Manager. Your chance to ask TV 38's Vice President and General Manager, Joseph C. DeVito, questions about TV 38 and or the broadcasting industry in general. Ask the Manager is pre-recorded.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Ask the Manager. Joe Domino was called to a business meeting, and he's decided to take a few days off. And so, consequently, he's not here today to do Ask the Manager. So what we thought we would do, instead of answering viewer questions, we would answer a frequent viewer request. And that is to show you our station, literally, from the outside in. This is George Storer, the man, late George Storer, as I told you about. He is responsible for the entire Storer Broadcasting chain, all of our stations. A remarkable man, self-made man. Let's walk down to Joe's real office. As I mentioned, now, that the office that we use on Ask the Manager, of course, is a television set down in Studio A. This is Joe's real office. As you come in here, here's Joe's secretary, Tricia.
Hello, Tricia. Tricia's Australian. She's married to a kangaroo, actually.
And as you come in here, now, this is Joe's real office, which is a lot more plush, you'll see in a moment, than downstairs. It's really nice. There's a nice arch window here. I always wanted to do this. Anybody looking? I like it. It's got a nice feel to it. Yeah, if you look over there, now, Joe has six television monitors. And what that allows him to do is not only, actually a seven, I guess, with the videotape machines and whatever. It allows him to watch not only our programming quite seriously, but every other station in town. He can monitor as he sits here at his desk and reads the New York Times. I don't know exactly what's done. A lot of big things happening here. I guess that's enough of Joe's office. These are all antiques, I guess. I don't know. As you come through here, this office here that is closed because there's a big meeting going on. This office in here is Dan Brookery's office. Dan filled in for Joe when he was on vacation. That's why we're doing this, and Dan's not doing the show now. As you come out into the corridor here, this, remember now, is what we're calling the third floor of the station. There are three levels, remember. Over there, we have our accounting offices. This is our operations manager's office. Dick Beach, with everybody but Dick Beach in it. We walk through our corridor here. Oh, let's go on down to sales. The sales office is kind of a unique office. I see everybody running in sales. The sales office is kind of unique. I mean, they're sort of the life's blood of the station, you know what I mean? They keep the money rolling in. I'm going to ask the camera to stay outside just for a moment because I'm going to make sure that everybody's decent in here. A lot of strange goings on in this area here. Everybody sober? 11 o'clock in the morning, that would be a record, wouldn't it? Come on in. Let's walk into the sales office here. These are some great guys and gals in here. They just keep things moving.
Ask the Everybody. Manager?
Yeah.
Yes, it does a 5 rating and an 8 share.
Ask
it's
the manager?
$1,000 a 30? No, I'm sorry, it won't clear. We need $1,200.
Are the funds rolling in, are they?
Oh,
are we doing?
Ask the Manager is our hottest show on TV right now. We're selling it as sponsorships, $2,000 a 30. It's going great.
You got that speech down pretty pat. You and Joe get along real well, don't think. Okay, anyway, I'd introduce you to everybody, but it would take far too much time, and besides that, most of these guys are pretty dull.
Probably the
Diddler, by the way, Dan. Thank you, everybody. This is the film area. This is where all of the editing is done here at TV 38. All of our film editing, of course. We also store some of our videotapes here. As you see, there are racks and racks and racks of film here, because not only do we keep our feature films in the film area, but also our Bewitched episodes and our Honeymooners episodes and Hogan's Heroes. All of those programs have to be stored here somewhere around the film area. This is Ron Dearborn. He is one of our film editors. What are you editing right now?
Movie called The Killers, Lee Marvin.
Right, and this is one of our new editing machines, isn't it? We have how many of these?
Three
of these, and exactly how do they work?
Well, they're, as you can see, it just stopped by itself. It's a fairly automatic system. It feels and inspects the film by itself and
inspects the film for any broken sprocket holes and that kind of thing?
Sprocket holes, damaged soundtracks, imperfections.
And also cleans the film, doesn't
right,
it?
Right, it cleans, it dry cleans the film over here. And also wet cleans the film on this side, if we so desire. If a film is in bad condition or it's a little older print, we'll run it through the liquid cleaner.
But as a film editor, exactly what do? You take time out of movies or make them fit certain time slots? Or
basically, we have to cut breaks into them according to the length of time that the movie is running. If it's a 2-hour movie, we generally have about 8 breaks in it. And if the movie runs longer than it should run and needs to be cut or edited, we edit it down to the length that it should run.
You like your job?
Yeah, I like my job.
You like to work on movies better than syndicated programming?
Well, like... Especially Loft movies. I really like the guy that hosts the show.
Yeah, he's great, isn't that guy? What is that guy's name?
Jesus, it escapes me right now.
It's Dana Hersey.
Right, Dana Hersey.
Okay, enough of Ron's interview. Okay, let's just keep walking around here for a minute. As Ron mentioned, we have three of these machines that do most of our editing. Very time-consuming job, but one that takes a lot of expertise and a developed skill and a talent as well. Let's just continue walking down through here. These, as I mentioned, are all films that we own. Some of the titles, Flight to Moscow, Billy the Kid versus Dracula, one of the biggies, The Tamarind Seed, Riders in the Rain, all kinds of... I'll show you our film library. It's right off Cliff's office. I want to walk out here into the corridor. This is Tom Larson's office. Hello there. Tom has a couple of production assistants, an assistant producer, and... Tom is not in right now, but it's 11 o'clock and he's probably gone home for the day. Okay, if you walk down here now and continue down, this is our art department, a very important department for a television station. They not only work on promotional material and work on advertising material, commercial material, they're responsible for all our graphics. Hi, Ara. Ara, one of our artists here, one of our three in residence. Isn't that correct? There's three of you, right?
Three.
Unless it's changed, hasn't it, Ara, in the past?
No.
What exactly do you do all day, Ara?
Graphic design work, on-air promotion.
Can you show me us example of what you're working on now? Is this something for out of house, is it?
No, this is...
This is a hobby of yours you're working on. A
freelance job, no. This is
You're just kidding. He's just kidding, by the way.
This is a slide presentation for the sales department, where we're putting together a package for them to promote television using the vehicles of the Red Sox and the Boston Bruins to promote the station.
But you guys are responsible for everything from set design in the station to this kind of work, graphics work and commercial work you work on.
Mm-hmm.
You do a lot of our supers and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, that's correct.
Can you show us an example of something else you do?
Well, right now we're working on a 4th of July slide, which... be right here, where that we compose the photograph and then to the theme, and then we'll have type burnt into it and then show it on air.
This is our sports department area in here. Just office area. There's Terry Toland, our production manager. He's the guy that's responsible for scheduling Ask the Manager. And here's Meg. Meg Levine. This is manager is going on the road, Jerry Powers, who's in charge of keeping all this room together. I did. I mentioned Meg Levine over here. Shoot in through the door in Tara's office there. Oh, give us a big smile, Meg. Meg is the producer of Forum 38. Right, which airs on Sundays here on TV 38, over most of these television stations. I always wanted to say that. Let's move on down to the promotion department. Excuse me, Tricia. Pardon me, Eileen. Hello, Mary Beth.
Oh, Jane.
Hi, Nick. Now, these are, Mary Beth is responsible for compiling a lot of statistics on our ratings, which she coordinates with the sales department in presentations, sales presentations, that kind of thing. Nick is responsible for a lot of our on-air promotion and doing a lot of work in the promotion department. This is Eileen Cushing's desk. Eileen helps out with Movie Loft and Forum 38, and Eileen does... And she's helping out today with Ask the Manager. Here's Eileen. In here, this is our program director in here. This is Judy Jurisich. Judy is really camera shy. In here is the executive producer's office. I'd introduce you, but I don't know who that is this week. As we come in here, this is Ellie Hashin's office. She's our... This is an interesting place for a TV set. Does the fire chief know about this? This is Ellie Hessian's office. She is our promotion director. And she is on vacation. This is Anna Ewan. Anna is the assistant promotion director and who is in charge of everything today.